Good morning, friends. I am Dr. K. S. Dasgupta, Director of Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information Communication Technology, situated in Gandhinagar, Gujarat. This is a state private university by the Act of Legislation of Government of Gujarat. This institute was established in 2001. And it is one of its kind institute in information communication technology. And let me also at the outset thank the College Duniya for inviting me to share my experiences with the young and the bright minds of our country. And also this is very apt in this particular point. Where all of us are suffering from COVID-19 pandemic, especially this pandemic has affected all our people all across the country, also across the globe, and because of which all of us, our economics, our business, our economy, everything has shattered to the roots. So at this point in time, if we can interact with the students and we can interact with the young minds, that will give some sort of a solid bonding with them, and also it will create a trust among them, and this is an opportunity where we can come closer to the students community who are virtually connected with us because of such an unprecedented situation. But before I start the discussion, let me give a quick rundown of my academic activities. I have spent many decades in academics, research, also in R&D. I was initially in Space Application Center of ISRO, where I was holding many important portfolios, and the most important is that I was the director of Development Communication Unit DECU, which was established basically by ISRO to capture the societal needs of the people in India, and then how to convert the societal needs into mission project applications and with certain objectives, and how these objectives can be converted into space space-based applications program. Prior to joining this particular institute, I was involved in, I was the director of another prestigious university called Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology, which is situated in Trivandrum, Kerala. And I was the, this institute was part of Department of Space as a society, and it was deemed, it is a deemed university under UGC's Act. And moreover, the purpose of, it's a national institute, public funded, and the basic goal of this institute was to produce quality human resources who can take up challenges of ISRO, both in terms of science and technology. And there we used to take, get the bright students, and hence my association in academics as well as research and R&D goes for many decades.
Sir. Okay, sir, thank you for your introduction. So let me start by asking you the question that you have held key positions at different education institutes throughout your professional career. What are the key factors that keeps you connected with the education sector?
Oh, this is a very good question so far as connection with the students are concerned. But you know, for any academic institute, if you see, they depend on three pillars. One is academics, of course, and the second one is the research and innovation. And the third one is basically the societal output, which comes from the institute. Now, these three, this particular triangle, or these particular three pillars are connected in such a way that the students, faculty members are involved in the cutting edge technology. And also important point here is the challenges what we get in academics and R&D. Now, the connection with the student is the most important activity. The connection in terms of discussions, deliberations, and debate. And you know, the most important point is when this young mind asks us questions, and which is out of box or very innovative questions that enrich us, because that gives us the energy, that gives us the motivation in pursuing further in this particular field, which is always a lifelong learning so far as all of us are concerned.
Very nicely put up. So, sir, the next question I would like to ask you, sir, being the director of Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information and Communication Technology, what is your philosophy of leadership and how would you describe your leadership styles?
Okay, you know, being I have spent primary time in Indian Space Research Organization Department of Space. I believe if you want to become a leader, or if I may be considered a leader, the first point one we have to understand is we should work in a team, and the leader is a mentor, leader is a guide, leader is a friend and philosopher too. Now, in this case, when you want to become a leader, you should be able to share more and take less. What does it mean? That you should be able to share your knowledge among the team members. That is the point number one. And you should be a shock absorber. That means when in the time when the project is not going well, when there are certain difficulties, certain failure, you should be able to absorb the shock, but you should not pass on to the students, to the team leader, team members. And also, you should not thrust your ideas or your opinion on the team members, because team members are the important stakeholders of the project or the program. So you should try to motivate them and try to get answer from them. And another very important point here is that once you are a leader in any discussion, you should be able to get the key points, which are the actionable points, which you can walk on. And another important point is that you should be able to present your team members in front of external agencies, in front of external experts, because they are basically your the strength, and they are basically the reflection of yours. Leadership. That is the thing. And the last point is that if there is a success, don't demand that success, pass on that success to the team members. And I'm sure when team members sees that leader is leading from the front, leader is motivating them, and leader is not, and also willing to share the knowledge and a part of the team member, then I'm sure the leader will be respected. Leader will be, their value, their opinions, their instructions will be followed.
Very nicely answered. So, sir, moving on to the next question, I would like to ask you, sir, being the director of Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information and Communication Technology, how do you strategize about the key programs and plans for the marketing administration of your institute?
See, the current education system is very competitive, and we cannot be static. That is the point number one. There is a saying that if there is an avalanche, you should be moving, otherwise you will. What I feel strategize is that we need to be agile and proactive. We should be ready to take challenges, introduce new programs, new research plan. Yeah, and you should be able to do that such that you grab the demand of the market and you are ahead of others. Now, for that, the most important is you should have an excellent industry connect, which will allow you to understand, to appreciate, to capture what is the industry's need, in terms of academics, in terms of skill development, and that will allow you to set up your program as per the industry's requirement. We also understand that in an institute like ours, we have to see that the important stakeholders are basically the faculty members and the students. They should be they should be busy in cutting edge research. And in our institute, if you know, it is basically the research and innovations are embedded in academic program, which says that academics is important, but research innovation are also equally important. Now the and the last point perhaps is that in an institute like Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information Communication Technology or any other premier institute like us, ours, the most important is that any decision which we take should be transparent. Any decisions we take should be with conviction and logical reasoning, because if I am sure that if there is a conviction, there is a sincerity, there is a dedication, and there is a purpose in taking a decision, all the stakeholders will be interested, will be believing us, and will have a trust on it. The trust development is very, very important, because the moment we get disconnected with the faculty, the moment we get disconnected with the students, our existence is no longer relevant. So in order to, for any director, and as a matter of fact, should be close to the students, close to the faculties, and you know, we have to, we should act more as a mentor rather than as an administrative head.
Okay, sir. So, I would like to get your views on this. As you know, sir, the education system in India and other foreign countries, they are structured very differently, sir. So, in your experience, what can the student gain from studying at your institute?
Yes, you know, you are talking about the inbound students who come from abroad, and for a country like India, it is very, very important. And now there is one more. You know, there is always says that whenever there is a disaster, there is some advantages too. And pandemic has stopped many students going abroad because of this sort of an unprecedented situation. So, if this is the case, any institute should be forward-looking to take the you know, students who are going abroad to study in an institute like DIICT or any other leading institute. But what to do for that? For that, we have to have interesting programs, academic program. You should be having a very strong research background, and also, you know, the most importantly, that we should have a lot of options of the choice-based selection of the courses. Now, you know, our institute is also like IIT Bombay or any other leading IITs, where we have some concept called, you know, one is the depth of a subject, as well as another is the breadth of areas of the elective. So we provide the core subjects as well as many electives, and our electives should be contemporary. Our electives should be relevant. For example, this year we have introduced a program which is a very unique program, which is called MSc in Data Science. We're doing very well. Data science is the is going to be creating a lot of impact in next decade or even more. So this sort of a program, another important undergraduate program which we have introduced is BTech in Maths and Computing. You may ask me, what is the speciality of Maths and Computing? Maths and Computing allows you to have a strong maths as well as a computing knowledge, which will allow you to go to AI, ML and so on like that. So I believe if the students who come from abroad look for variability, and also looks for the depth, and also they want to connect with the research such that they get the live issues, the problems, and they try to handle that, and they get a pleasure, they get a satisfaction. So this is a very right time, or it's an apt moment where institute like ours have to keep eyes and ears open and such that, and make the, unfortunately our courses were designed in such a way that it has both in terms of depth as well as in terms of breadth. A lot of electives are there, and electives are selected as per the industrial need, as per the research requirement of R&D organization. So I'm sure that the students come, inbound students will be getting attracted to this new programs.
Yes, sir, very nicely put that. So the next question I would like to ask you, sir, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the institute and the students are?
If you ask me that what is my role as a director or as this one, I consider myself more as a mentor who is a navigator. My job is to navigate the program in such a way that the institute students get benefited, faculty gets more motivated, and at the same time, what happens is that the perception about the institute increases or improves. Now, perception is a very important parameter in the national or international ranking. And also, if the perception is good, ranking is high, we get better students. Not only better students, we get better faculties. And the faculty's selection and the faculty's joining in the institute is a big responsibility and a commitment for a director. Because, I believe if I make a mistake in recruiting a faculty, that is basically a permanent damage to the institute. So we we are very selective. We are very choosy in taking faculty members. And with not only our, we interview with outside experts. We see their credentials in research. So, and such that once they are inducted, they become our asset, and they only they drive the whole program. And the another important point here is that any institute, the research power is very important. Research power is a function of volume of publication, as well as what is the quality of publication. Now, this if we want to be relevant, if we want to be significant in this sector, then our research power should be very high, and the research power should allow us to be ahead of many others.
Yes, sir. So for the next question I would like to ask you, sir, what do you see Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information and Communication Technology greatest strength?
Okay. Now, so far as the greatest strength is concerned, I tell you, we are the first ICT-based institute in India, and that was in 2001. Now you see the vision. 2001, we envisaged and we understood that ICT-based information institute are very important, you see. So that was the first year we have an undergraduate program on ICT, and which is where ICT is basically a fusion of computer science and electronics and communication, because you need computer science fundamentals, you need technology in terms of, let us say, wireless communication, let us say some of the VLSI designs. So you try to see a fusion of undergraduate program, the computer science and electronics and communication. Now, all our programs, if you see in our institute, is very unique in the sense is we do some sort of a fusion of humanities and social science with engineering. Then you may be asking, or many experts may ask me, what is the relevance of it? We don't want robots. We want human being who has appreciation of the society, who understands what is the societal need, who can contribute in developing appropriate technology. So this process of and we don't have only, you know, as per the UGC guideline, we have only eight or ten credit. We have a completely cascaded program which goes even up to the seventh semester for different type of social science, science and technology and engineering, all these things. So this is one unique feature we have. And one more unique feature what we have, which I think others in Gujarat or anywhere it may not be having, we have called rural internship. In the second year, it is mandatory. And the part, and this is being conducted by the NGOs. They go to the remote rural areas and try to understand what type of living conditions they are and whether they can help them. And in fact, I'm very happy to tell you, the students spend almost 1 month or even more than that, according to me, engineers should not be in an air-conditioned room. Engineers should also understand what is the understand the ecosystem in the rural places or the rural villages, how they work. So this is an unique USP of our institute. And our institute also believe in competitive intelligence such that we want to become global. If you want to become a global leader, you should have more knowledge, sound knowledge in science and technology. So we always believe that you cannot have only fundamental research. It cannot be only blue sky research. It should be also applied research which will enable the students to help the society.
This is very nicely put up. So the next question I would like to ask you, sir, what do you think should be the institute's top priority over the next 10 years?
This is a very challenging task and time, because early days what you used to do, once you set up an institute, you can say, you can dictate terms. But in a modern world, you cannot dictate terms. It is the student-centric, and the students will decide whether they will come to the institute or they will not come to the institute. And they will come to the institute not because of your infrastructure, not because of your research, good hostels and so on and so forth. They will come when there are interesting programs, when there are challenges in research, and when there are some innovation related activity, startup related activities. So what we want to be interested in another 10 years, we should be relevant and globally. And global relevance is possible when you improve the perception about our institute. Now, our wishful thinking is that in 10 years, our target is we should be in top 50 in NIRF ranking, and also globally we should be within 400, such that it's a win-win situation. If we improve our ranking both nationally and globally, we get better faculty members who want to come to us, and another is because we have better faculty members and ranking, and then better students come. And if better students come, it is basically a ecosystem which becomes vibrant and which becomes very, very effective and productive. And another important point which we need to understand is that we cannot stand alone. It has to be a collaborative program, and the collaboration should be international, national level. And this collaboration should be multinational and also multidisciplinary collaboration. Now, I want to tell you, we have done something unique already. We have a certain program with IIT Jammu, which is called an academic program in M.Tech in computer science, with specialization in data science. computer science specialization in information security, because we wanted to synergize the strength of IIT Jammu as well as our strength in teaching. So it is like one semester they study there, another semester they study here, and the final year project, either they do it at IIT Jammu or in our campus. So another important point we have done is we have done another program with C.R. Rao Advanced Institute of Math, Statistics and Computer Science, that is called EPTEC in Electronics and Communication, specialization in wireless communication and embedded system. Now, this sort of collaborative program gives a lot of varieties to the students, and the more students will come, because you know, it is not a brute force method of attracting the student. You have to attract the students with the quality program and with the quality faculty and international connection. Now, another important thing which we are already talking, that you know, we can have a joint research program with international institutes of repute, where, for example, if somebody registered here, there will be a joint supervision, publication will be joint, which will enhance the potential of the student as well as the guide. And once publications increases, that also is a feather in the cap of any institute, you know. And we want to have an exchange program. Already we are doing some exchange program, but the exchange program should not be unilateral. It should be bilateral exchange program. Because, you know, as you are saying, that inbound students, the student from US or other countries should come here, and our students should able to go. So there should be a cross-culture of the students, and that way the campus will be more vibrant, campus will be more energetic, and campus will be more, productive.
Very nice. So moving on to the next question, I would like to ask, what was your vision for the institute, and has it evolved over time, and how far in implementing that vision are you?
We cannot give education just for giving education. We have to give education which is relevant, which is contextual, and also which industry accepts it. Because ultimately, every student is not going to do a PhD. Every student is not going to join an R&D organization like ISRO or BARC and so on and so forth. So we have to make sure the students are employable, students have necessary skill, and students also have the potential to upskill their knowledge in terms of the new techniques and technology. Now, if you ask me, initially it was having an undergraduate program in ICT, and then we extended it to another program called BTech in ICT with minor in computational science, which is also an important program, and the best students in Gujarat we get. And I'm very happy that many of the students do PhD in a very leading institute in US, and also some of the people are doing PhD in India also. Now, if you see, our vision is that our intellectual competitiveness has to be enhanced, such that we should be able to have a global leadership. And when you want to have a global leadership, we want students across the globe. We want faculties both at the international and national level. And at the same time, we want projects both from India as well as in the abroad. And you know, we follow the best practices, and the best practices which are being followed in the leading institutes like IITs, we have it. As I told you, the students can select the electives depending upon the choice. Students are evaluated in a continuous basis, and students are given a lot of projects, a lot of they have some research clubs where they want to do certain small researches. They have electronics innovation club, and they have we have a on-campus startup which allows the students which is called SSIP, Student Startup Innovation Program. We are part of in that, and we have an SSR students do a lot of startup programs. We, as I told you, that we are pioneer in introducing undergraduate program in ICT, and also we are introducing a lot of UG and PG programs, which already I have told you. One UG program which we are starting from this academic year is BTech in Maths and Computing. Another PG program which we are starting from this year is called MSc in Data Science, which is also very well accepted program, and a lot of students are interested in joining our program. We have collaborative programs with the top institutes in the country, such as IITs, which I also have explained that we have a joint program with IIT Jammu in case of computer M.Tech in computer science with specialization in data science, M.Tech in computer science with specialization in information security. The second batch is going to join us now, and this is also a unique case where an IIT and an institute like ours are joining together, synergizing their strengths and trying to introduce new program in M.Tech. That is also an important thing. And we are very happy to tell you that, you know, we have a strong information retrieval and language processing team, and they are consortia of many projects with IITs and other leading institutes in India. And another important point here is that we have almost 20% of graduates every year. They go to foreign studies in very reputed institutes like CMU, like University of Berkeley, and all these places. So our students are well accepted both nationally as well as internationally, and we are open for any sort of association with them, which will lead us to have a bigger umbrella where the students will get a much more stronger ecosystem, which will allow them to learn better and also to come prosper in a much more way, significant way compared to any other institute.
Sir, moving on to the next question, I would like to ask you, what are some of the biggest challenges you see, both for higher education in general and for BAICT specifically?
Okay, the first, the biggest challenge if you see is to how to remain relevant in modern transforming education system. And I mentioned earlier, the research power is very important of any institute, which is in, reflected in terms of number of publications, as well as the quality of publications, like H index and other related things. So we wanted to have good publications, quality publication. So that is also very, very important for an institute to grow. And another thing is that we should be ready for change or seamlessly, or orient the academic program or the research program to meet the need of the industries and the R&D organization. So we should not be very static. We should be dynamic. We should be able to capture the needs of the industry and the expectation of the students, and then we introduce new program. So we are always looking for the new programs, but the program which is relevant, which are being accepted by the students and which are being liked by the students, that sort of a new program we are trying to do. Another important thing which we are trying to think about is that we want to introduce an online program for upscaling the knowledge of professionals, and this will be basically online, and it will be blended. Some of the some of the professionals may come for a week or so in a semester, and they will study that. It could be a 1 year or a 9 months or 10 months diploma program, which we are seriously thinking and trying to see whether we can not only our faculties teach that, but we also take leading faculties from other industries and R&D organizations.
Okay, sir. So moving on to the next question, I would like to ask you, sir, what are some of the plans that you are or will be designing for Dubai Ambani Institute of Information and Communication Technology for better international exposure for students and staffs?
Okay, this is a very important, nowadays no institute can be locally relevant but internationally not relevant. If you have to be relevant, you have to be relevant both nationally as well as internationally. Now, we are having many MOUs with foreign universities, and now we are thinking of having a letter of understanding with University of Auckland, but it is in the process of discussion. And then we want, as I told you, we want joint supervision with a guide, one from international, one from national. There should be an exchange program where the students can spend 1 month for 1 year or 6 months there, and then come back to get an exposure of the foreign education ecosystem. And in addition to that, you should have a sponsored program. The sponsored program, research program, is that internationally as well as nationally. Already, we are, for your information, we are already giving. We have connected with a lot of international R&D programs nationally, not internationally completely. Nationally, with leading R&D institute like ISRO and DST and in the government of Gujarat, DST as well as the DST of the center. So that way, we are very proactive, and we are also interested in enhance our capabilities. And also, we want to put our activity chart more longer and the bigger, such that many such programs we can introduce in the years to come.
Okay, sir. So, sir, the next good question I would be asking you, sir: how do you tend to establish a healthy relation and environment in your institute?
You see, the healthy relation and environment is very important. The important point here is there should be synergy between the faculties, administration, as well as the students. Now, the synergy comes on the one is students are happy when you make good hostels. Students are happy when you have a good cafeteria. But beyond that, students are nowadays are very demanding in terms of challenges which you give them in their academic program as well as in the research program. So we have to give more challenges to them, and if we give more challenges, they will be busy in doing more activities, and they will be more concentrated, focusing on their research. So, and another important point here is that our any administrative activity should be transparent and should be such that it cannot satisfy 100%, but it should satisfy at least 80-90% of the stakeholders of our institute.
The answer. So the last question I would be asking you, sir, is your suggestions, what you would like to give current youth and the aspiring students.
Okay, I have a request to all the students: that define a goal in your life, but don't change the goal too often. Because once you change the goal, in a football match, you can change the goal post every time you like. So define your goal, stick to that, be focused. And also be proactive, not reactive, and have a very strong academic foundation such that in future you can go to for different options. You can change your course learning, and you can upscale your learning, which is at that particular time relevant. if you're found, it is like this, you know, if you have a house, if your foundation is strong, you can make the first ground floor a first, then first floor and second floor. So the foundation cannot be compromised. Students should be focused. Students should be dedicated. Students should have perseverance, and students should be open to accept the suggestions as well as the criticism. And on one thing, I want to tell students that we are with you. We will be with you, and you should have a trust. You should have faith in us that everything will be in position.